This month is our month. This month is my month. This month is your month. This month is your... Declare, he said, this is my month. Whether Satan like it or not, this is my month. What is the prophetic word for us this month? What is the prophetic focus for us this month? Let's say it louder. Of the zeal of God. Again. My miracle month. Say it again.
This is my month
of the zeal of God. My miracle month. I prophesy to you as you declare it to yourself. This is your miracle month.
Amen.
I said this is your miracle month.
Amen.
What has never happened in your life will happen this week.
Amen.
What is a miracle? Miracle is what I don't qualify for. Miracle is what I don't know how it happens. This month is your miracle month.
Amen.
This month is your testimony month.
Amen.
When you will come to the altar and share your testimony, everybody will say, this is a miracle. This is what? A miracle. I speak into your life. Receive this prophetic order. I speak to the atmosphere. I speak to the head. Whatever will make your miracle louder, whatever will make your miracle to be the first, it will happen immediately after this service. It will happen from this service. In the name of Jesus, this is your miracle week. Not your miracle month only, but your miracle week. Within the next 72 hours, Ekubrado Shate Kerondo Pledi Litalia Soto Plekita Yata Yakata. Within the next 72 hours, beginning from this minute, beginning from this second, when God speaks, everything hear the word of God. When his prophet speak, everything surrender to the voice of his prophet. If I am a prophet of the Lord, hear me. Before the end of this service, by the end of this service, by the end of today, by tomorrow morning, by Tuesday, Wednesday, there shall be a miracle.
Amen.
There shall be a miracle of the man.
Amen.
I receive.
Prophet said to the people, he said, by this time tomorrow, if I be a servant of the Lord, of whom I know I am, I have been proven and tested upon nation to nations, upon man to man. I am not speaking by myself. I'm speaking by the unction and authority of God upon my life.
Yes, sir.
And I declare to everyone,
I receive,
under the sound of my voice,
I receive,
that this month, this week, is your week of miracle.
Amen.
Your week of miracle.
Amen.
Your week of answer prayer.
Amen.
Everyone looking for job.
Jesus.
Take it right now. Take your job right now.
I receive.
Take your contract right now.
I receive.
Take your employment right now.
I receive.
Take your promotion right now. Take it, take it, take it, take it, take it, take it.
I receive it.
I receive it.
Angels, hear my voice.
I receive.
Now, I speak to every financial crisis, every one under financial challenges. If I am sent of the Lord, hear me. There was a point in time when I was in Europe and I put the ATM card in Europe, and before I can put my ATM, £50 dispense. There are angels that dispense it. They work with me. They hear my word. When I assign angels, they listen to me.
I connect.
Hear me. I said I am not a prophet of the Lord. Right now, I command a financial miracle.
Yes, sir.
Financial miracle.
Yes, sir.
Financial miracle.
Yes, sir.
Come on, take it, take it, take it, take
I
it,
receive,
take it, take it. Financial miracle.
I receive.
This week.
I receive.
Hey! Whatever God can give you and that he planned to give you in December, I've got the power to command it today.
Yes, sir.
And I'm commanding that job. I commanded that promotion.
Jesus.
I'm commanding that situation.
Amen.
To hear the word of God right now.
Yes, Lord.
If it is not today, if it is not tomorrow, if it is not Wednesday,
yes, sir.
It's no more testimony. It's a lock. And I know I'm serving the God of miracle.
Yes, sir.
The God of talking ado.
Yes, sir.
The God of 2 hours.
Yes, sir.
That my God. That my God.
Yes, sir.
I challenge him for you. I challenge my God for you.
I hear you, sir.
That we do this morning and Wednesday.
Yes, sir.
Listen to me.
I hear you, sir.
If there is no war,
yes.
If there is no testimony between today and Wednesday, that everybody will know, then I will drop the microphone.
Yes.
I will what?
Drop the microphone.
I will what?
Drop the microphone.
God, you didn't send me. I promise you that. Next Sunday, then Brother Ese or Brother James or Brother or Edda will come and preach. If there is no recorded testimony between this morning and Wednesday,
I
am very proud of what I'm saying.
I hear you, sir.
Children of God,
yes, sir.
Challenge me by Sunday and say, God, Father, you said there will be testimony. I know what I'm saying. Every year me. If God sent me, remember, one day I said to the elders, if God did not send us, if we didn't get a venue by that month, I said, God, scatter us. And as I spoke, it was in the morning, and the following morning, less than 12 hours, they called me. Pastor, we find a place for you. And we have been looking for a place for 3 months. Who done that? The same God that hear my voice. I speak it and I command him now. He said he has given me the authority. He said, command ye me the work of my hand. So I am not speaking vain word. I am standing upon his word. And I'm commanding him that the testimony that will make you to believe that this man is sent of the Lord,
yes, sir,
will reach your hand.
Amen.
Within the next 72 hours.
I receive.
Take it.
I receive.
Whatever you are believing God, lift up your voice right now. Lift up your voice right now. Begin to declare it that this man, this man, this man, this man, this man, this week, this week. Hey! I command them to come. I command them to come. Your houses.
I receive. In the name of Jesus, I receive.
Take your job.
I receive.
Take your promotion.
I receive.
Take your houses.
I receive.
Take your career.
I receive.
Take your employment.
I receive.
Take your healing.
I receive.
Take your healing. Take your healing. Take your healing.
Healing.
Yes, 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 yes. No.
I receive. In the name of Jesus.
Miracle workers. Hey!
Miracle workers.
Yes! Lift up your hands and hands. Praise him!
A miracle today.
Yes! Come on!
Come and do a miracle. A miracle today.
Come on! Let's command it!
Destiny changer.
Aye!
You are a destiny changer.
Yeah, that's who he is!
Come and change a destiny. A destiny today.
When is he today?
Come and change a destiny. A destiny today.
Oh yes, it's today.
It's Yahweh.
It's today. Today.
Your name is Yahweh.
It's today. It's today.
You are a miracle walking God. Your name is Yahweh.
Hey.
Yahweh. Yahweh. Your name is Yahweh.
Ah.
You are a miracle walking God. Your name is Yahweh.
Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, can't you see why I'm celebrating?
I am celebrating.
Because it is done.
It is done.
You will hear my testimony.
You will hear my testimony.
Next Sunday service.
Next Wednesday.
Don't come late.
Don't come late.
You will hear my testimony.
You will hear my testimony.
Please be seated. Give the Lord a clap of it. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 9. God said to us that this is going to be our month of miracle. Our month of what? Miracle. Our month of what?
Miracle.
I want to teach you something this month that will change your impression about, that will give you freedom and that will tell you more about God. You know what? Let me say it clearly right now. Miracle is not by anybody design. It is by God auction alone. Miracle happens not by, hear me, whatever I want to say. Hear me? Miracle happen not by men, but by God. And miracle happen when higher authority commanded God to do it. Can I give you another secret of miracle? Miracle is not by function of your faith. Write it down. It will surprise you what I want to teach you now. It will surprise you what I want to teach you now. Miracle has nothing to do with your faith. There is a time of faith. Are you getting me? There is a time of miracle. Miracle has nothing to do with your faith. If it is by faith, there will never be miracle. Because when miracle happens, unbelievable things happen. Hello?
Hi.
When a aircraft crack and people's or one or two persons survive, at that particular time, it is not the faith. It is the miracle. It is God himself that want to prove to the whole world that I am still God. When a aircraft landed and all cracked and the people survived, are you telling me that the pilot is a Christian? So how can you say it was his faith? But God wants to prove to that pilot that winner, I am God. Okay, I give you another point now. In the wilderness, when Jesus saw the multitude, he said, is there anybody here? Is there anybody with anything we can give? Even one of his disciples, he said, Master, what are you talking? You are talking jargons. How can we feed these people in the wilderness? But, you know, the Bible says, and he tested him because Jesus himself knew what to do. He knew there is a miracle he can perform. His servant is servant. Himself. This man wants to disgrace himself today. He said, this man wants to disgrace himself today. He said, how can we feed people? But what happened? Miracle happened. It was not the faith of the people. It was the miracle of God. I mentioned to you that when God say it is a miracle, it is his miracle. Miracle happen because God wants to prove himself to his own people and that the world can know his own people. The miracle that will happen in your life this month will make people to know that you are a daughter of God.
Amen.
There are things that will happen in your life. Hear me? Every one of you. You will ask the Lord, why me? That is what? Miracle. Hallelujah. However, the place of faith is to believe that there is God that can do miracle. Your faith is to be assured that I have a miracle God who can do all things.
I hear you, sir.
But you don't know where he will come for you. But he will come for you this month.
Amen.
This week.
Amen.
This is our miracle
month. Amen.
This is our miracle month.
Amen.
1 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 9. He said, but as it is written, eyes had not seen, none ear had, neither have entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for them that love him. That what? That loved him. That is the plan of God for us this month. The miracle that God will do for you. For who? Those that love God. And I have good news. If you do not love God, you will not be in service today.
I hear you, sir.
That's giving an assurance that you are a candidate for
miracle.
Those that do not love God, they are in Sebi now. But you leave your bed to hear him. It shows you love him.
I hear you, sir.
Hear me? Whether you have faith or you don't have faith. In fact, the miracle you will receive this week will make you now to have faith.
Amen.
I receive.
In God. To be honest with you, except some people see miracle, they can never believe that there is God. Except some people see miracle, they can never believe that there is God. That miracle that you will receive this week will make you to believe that there is God in this place.
Amen.
I receive. I connect.
I'm not preaching this morning. It's a prophetic service.
I connect.
It's a prophetic service.
I hear you, sir.
Our I am going to do a thing. Please be seated. Ears have not heard it. That is what? Miracle. Eyes have not seen it. That is what?
Miracles.
Unseen event. Unheard event. How could you hear that suddenly? Okay, look at that, my son now. He just said 2-3 weeks he has been promoted. He has no university certificate or whatever. But what you are sharing now will be the least you will share this month.
Amen.
You hear me? You will go to doctor this week or this month. They will say, what are you doing here? Cancer free. HIV free.
Amen.
That is what? Miracles. They will call you, say, please come and take this thing. Come and take it. What they are saying is impossible. You ask yourself, how manage? That is what?
Miracle.
Listen to me. Don't fight people. Don't fight yourself. The reason why you are fighting yourself or you are fighting people is because you have not seen miracle. If miracle comes in your situation today, you will stop fighting that person because you will be too much for that person to handle. Say, oh Lord, lift up your hands.
Oh Lord,
show me your miracles.
Show me your miracles.
I am desperate.
I am desperate
for your miracle.
For your miracles.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
1 Samuel chapter 3 verse 11. We are opening the gate of this month. For what? The only testimony I want to be hearing on this month is miracle. 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 1 Samuel chapter 3 verse 11. Then the Lord said to Samuel, behold, I am about to do a thing in Israel, at which the 2 ears of everyone who hear it, it will. Hey, people of God, please. This month, you will be embarrassed by testimony.
Amen.
You will be embarrassed by testimony.
Amen.
The miracle of God will make you an embarrassment to his glory.
Amen.
I receive.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let me quickly read this plan of God. And how can I tap into that miracle? Then I will give us some miracle of the month. And then I will allow you to believe him or not. Haggai chapter 1 verse 1 that we read in the opening of the month. I'm just going to read some verses because of our time, but every one of us must read Haggai chapter 1 to the end. Read it and read it and read it throughout this month. This is the Bible reading for this month. Every one of us must read Haggai chapter 1 to the end. Every day when you are less busy, when you are not doing anything, your Bible reading, Haggai chapter 1 to the end. Let me quickly show you just small keyword of the month. Let's see this one together. One to go. In the second year of Darius, the king, in the sixth month, in the fourth day of the month, came the word of the Lord by Haggai, the prophet of the Zerubbabel. Say, in which month? First, in which month? In which month? In which month? What month is this? The Lord spoke to us already in the first day. People that were here, the Lord spoke to us already. And what the Lord said to us is that, tell my Wami family that this is my month of what? The zeal of the Lord. My miracle month. That's what the Lord spoke to us. And now you're going to have understanding why God says it is the zeal month. It is our miracle month. Verse 2. Thus speaketh the Lord of hosts, saying, these people say, the time is not come, the time that the Lord's house will be built. Verse 3, then came the word of the Lord by Haggai the prophet, saying, Is it time for you, O ye, to dwell in your silly houses? Your silly houses. And his house lie waste? Verse 5. Now therefore, thus said the Lord of hosts, consider your ways. Verse 7. Thus, how can we consider our ways? Thus said the Lord of hosts, again, consider your way. Did you see? He repeated it twice. Then, how can we consider our way if this is so important to him in the month of April and the month of June? He said in verse 8, go up to the mountains and bring wood and build the house. Which house? The house of the Lord. And I will take pleasure in it and I will be glorified, say the Lord. Verse 9, he said, if not, that's a warning. If not, you look for much, and lo, it came to lead you. And when you brought it to your home, I did blow it upon it. Why? Because the Lord said, of my house that is waste, and ye run every man into his own house. God said, listen to me. I want to do a miracle for you. But my miracle will be triggered by your love for me. That's what I'm saying now. This time around, it is not the place of faith. It is now the work of love. God said, okay, I'm finding it difficult to get people faith. But if I can get your love, say your love. If I can get your love, I will be able to prove your faith and I'll be able to show you my miracle. Many of us find it difficult to have faith in him, but there is something simple you can have for him. Love. Show him your love, he will show you his miracle. And then, let's look at Haggai chapter 1 verse 14. How can I show God my love? How can I show God my love? Haggai chapter 1 verse 14. And the Lord stir up the spirit of Zerubbabel and the spirit of Joshua and the spirit of all the remnant of the people, and they came and did work in the house of the Lord of hosts, their God. God is calling us this man to show him our love for him. And then we shall see his miracle. We shall see what?
His miracle.
Miracle. We shall see his miracle. So this man, God is demanding from every one of us that is expecting a miracle. He said, show me your love. When I can see your love, then I will show you my miracle. So, people of the Lord, we shall be looking this month at various ways of which we can prove and show God our love. Can I ask you a question from this moment? What is the love of God? How many of you love God? Let me see your hand. How many of you love God? How many of you love each other? How many of you love each other? You love somebody next to you? Ask your neighbor, say, neighbor, do you love me or do you hate me? Again, neighbor, do you love me or do you hate me? What does the person say? Or maybe they don't want to use the word. Say, I like you. Say, do you like me? Again, I ask you now, all of you, how many of you truly love God? Let me see your hand. Truly? Truly? Are you sure? Are you sure? Put your hands down. Mina, listen to me. Mina, I don't believe all of you. Why? Thank God. Clap for the Lord for that question. Mina, I can say to all of you that raised up your hand right now that Namanga. Namang. Eh? Tell your neighbor. Okay, ask your neighbor first. Say, neighbor, do you truly love God? What does he say? Tell him, tell her, say, Namanga. Namanga. I don't believe you. And I will prove to you now why I say I don't believe you. John chapter 5, verse 42. I don't believe you. Let's read it together. John chapter 5, verse 42. I'm not the one that says it now. Let's read it together. Let's read together. Again. But I know you. Let's read it together. That ye have not the love of God in. Tell your neighbor. Say neighbor. Say neighbor. According to John chapter 5, verse 42. But I know you. Tell your neighbor. Oh, yeah, read it for him. Read it for her. Read the rest. Finish the rest now. Finish the rest. Studio, we are still there. Oh, yeah, read it for him. Read it for her. Say, Wena. I know you. That you have not the love of God. Say, bam. Say, bam. So, am I the one that say it? Mama Fire, am I the one that say it? It is. Now, there is some responsibility. Now, you now have your own responsibility to prove to him that you love. You must prove to him that you love him. How can I prove to him? How can you prove to him that you love him? Deuteronomy chapter 6 verse 5 say, and thou shalt love the Lord with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy might. That is how to prove your love. How many of you love God with your heart and with your soul and with your mind? There is a call to service this month. The love of God. You want miracle? God said, I'm not a miracle waster. I'm a miracle maker. I'm not a miracle waster. I'm not a miracle waster. So when you are singing, come and do your miracle, miracle today. God is also saying, I'm not a miracle waster. I'm not a miracle waster. I will show you miracle when I see your heart. I will show my miracle when I see your heart. Miracle worker, miracle worker. Oh, yeah, sing it. Come and do your miracle, miracle today. Sing it.
Come and do a miracle, miracle today.
How many of you know that God also speak? Miracle seeker, miracle seeker. Come and show me your love. I will show my miracle. I'm not a miracle. I'm not a waster. I'm not a waster.
I'm a miracle walking God. I'm not a waster.
Hey! We shall do our CD.
Hallelujah.
God say, I'm not a miracle waster. Because you know why? The moment your heart is not with God, God will even regret that he gave you the miracle. Because it's not a waster of the miracle. Akere, now you see, we are seeing you in church now. Because that miracle you are still expecting. The moment the miracle reaches people and now, they disappear. They disappear. And that's why God, as you are singing, God is, his angel also are singing. He's not a miracle waster for all these people. The problem you are, you don't hear him was that your own voice is too louder. Whereas God's voice is small one. I'm not a miracle waster, oh boy. He wants his miracle. Show him your love. And hear me. For God so loved the world, John chapter 3, verse 16, that he gave his only begotten son. That whosoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. You love me, I can do anything for you. Just the way I gave my only begotten son. Because I love you and I gave. And I prove it. What do you have to prove that you love him? I'm going to help you today. How can you prove your love? When I said, do you love God? You said yes. And I said no. It's because why? I have measured you. I measure your love. I can't find where your loyalty is with God or with men. Hear me? I have one secret for you. If you want to prove to the Lord that you love me, there is what is called the zeal of the Lord. It is the zeal of the Lord that tested and that proving your love for him. You don't need to tell anybody that I love God. In this ministry, we know people that love God. And all of you know it. When we are talking about people that love God, you know it. Because you can see their zeal. Up and down to make things happen. 7 a.m. to make things happen. Rain and shine, the idea, it is their zeal. It is your zeal for God that will prove whether you love God or not. Nobody loves God with mouth. You can claim you love your wife or your partner now, and your wife or your partner cannot seal your zeal for him or for her. He will divorce you or she will divorce you. Because I love you. I love you. He didn't see the zeal. Me, I have a slogan in my house. And everybody know. My family member know. All my daughters in the house, they know. Abby? Huh? You know, when I come home, I sing, everybody know. All my family, if I ask them to now to come and stay, they will demonstrate for you. Forget, you know now. I love my mouth. I love my wife. It's not by mouth. Is by visa. I love my wife. I love my family. It's not by mouth. It's by Chinese rice. I love my wife. It's by nice perfume. Nice shoe. Even when my wife says, are you still in the office? I say, I'm coming. And so before I come, I say, I love my wife. Oh. Somebody jealous me because of my wife. Oh. I will throw what? I will throw a gift. And so you can see that my zeal. What is your zeal for the Lord? What is your zeal for your family? You'll be claiming and claiming, claiming, I love that woman, I love that man. Where is your zeal to show him or to show her? Love without a zeal. It is your zeal that will measure your love for anybody the same way for God. When I seal your zeal, you don't need to answer me. You don't need to tell me that I love God. I will tell you. People will even tell you that that guy, the way he loves God, you know, people will see it. People will see the way you jump up and down to put this together, to arrange something. People will see it is the zeal of God that measures your temperature, your spiritual temperature for God. Can I measure your spiritual temperature today? Many of you, you fail. The seal of God is simply the spiritual thermometer at which every love of God has been tested or has been demonstrated. There are different types of the love of God which are measured by your seal level. There are different types of love of God. Can I quickly show you this? I'm still going to show you some things. What do I have to gain from loving God? Then it will encourage you to sow your zeal. If there is nothing in it, God will not demand it from it. I keep telling you guys, people hear me, and I'm repeating it again. If God didn't give you anything, or if there is nothing gainful from God, then don't serve him. Can I show you your type of love and how to demonstrate your love and how your love will be measured via your zeal? I'm going to show you different type of love of God measured by the zeal, your zeal. Every one of you sitting here now, your zeal is being tested and is being announced right now. Number one, the thermometer of the love of God. The what? The thermometer of the love of God. Number one, there is active zeal of God. Active zeal of God. It is the zeal of God with a definite strong passion and commitment. This commitment is called agape love. Commitment is active zeal of the Lord is the strong commitment. And it is only the agape love. You just love him unconditionally. Why are you doing this to the house of the Lord? I just love God unconditionally. Nothing attached. But look at you now. You have been nothing. Whether I have the car, whether I have husband, whether I have girl, whether I have woman, whether I have business, I just love him. Least peace, people of God. That is, I am one of them that can tell you. Wake me up morning and night, 24/7, or the agape love in me will prove itself. It will prove itself. And all of you can see it. See, listen to me. Love of God is what is visible. It's not hidden. It's not hidden. If it is hidden, forget it. It's a lie. I will show you. Active zeal of God is the strong passion, commitment of your love to him. It will show. In fact, it will show in your face. People can see that this one is just being forced to come to church. He's just being forced to serve God. Number two, because I want to deliver quickly, the type of love that's being measured by the zeal, your zeal, is passive zeal. Passive. We have active, we have passive. Do you love God? Everybody say yes. Among all of you, there is active love, there is passive love. Measured by the zeal. Your zeal. It is your zeal that measures this. What is passive zeal? It is the zeal of God that's known as a gentle love of God, without any strong attachment or commitment. Passive zeal is the love of God without energy. You know me, I love God. Pastor, let me tell you the truth. Me, I love God. You love God? Don't you see that I love God? It's passive. Yes, they love God. They can come to church by 10 p.m., 10 a.m. Yes, they love God. They can come to church. They have a regular seat. Even, you can see, they've never sat here before. They go to their own seat. Or they never sit here before, they go to their own seat. Passive love. No struggle. God bless you. God bless you. Let's share the grace. Bye-bye. See you next Sunday. Passive love. No attachment, no commitment, but they love God. Are you not in church now? Hello? Are you not in church now? Are you not in church now? Because you love God. Thank God for that. But did you know how this chair was clean yesterday? But you still love God. And you still sit on that chair. The active people clean the chair. The passive people sit on it. Am I making sense to you? Without love of God, without energy. Number three, we have dormant, or call it dogmatic zeal. Dogmatic zeal. They love God, but they are dormant. Unless you activate them, they are here. Unless I tell Sister Tope, why are you not in cleaning yesterday? And anyway, she's not there. Were you there? I was not there, but you see now I'm the spirit realm. I pick you now. Dormant is there. They have it. You know that they don't have it. But it's dormant. It's like when your account is there, but it's not in operation. It's dormant. Until the FMB now send you a message. Excuse me, sir. Your account is dormant. You say, oh, okay. I'll put 50 around there again. Then you relax again. They are dormant. You love God. I thank God that you are here. But your love, when being measured by zeal, is dormant. Think about anything you can think. I will be short about it. And then, because this dormant love, this is a love with or without energy. And it is the love without knowledge. With profitable to no one. It is also called destructive love. This dormant love is called destructive. They are what? They are destructive. Because they are dormant. They are not active. They just do everything on their own. And they are destructive because I would have thought that, okay, Brother Joseph will have been in church. Whereas, he's a dormant love. He's not there. And he would have distracted me. When you see this kind of people in church, when she stand up right now, I would think she's going to toilet to go and clean the toilet. No, she just go there and ease herself and come back. Even when she see the toilet block, the protocol people will come and clean it. But if you say, go and clean that toilet, okay, yes, sir, I will go. It's there, but it's trauma. God said, and you want me to give you a miracle? If I give you this miracle, this today, I won't see you on Sunday because you are so dumb. Another one, fourth one, is I service love. I service love of God. When God measure and the zeal of God measure your temperature for him, he said, this one is I service love. Hey! Pastor Tao is coming now. Let me quickly stand at the gate so that he can know that I've been in this gate since morning. It's a lie. He was just that gate for 2 minutes. I service. Hey! Daddy. We love you. I service. That service, that I love you just for that moment. I give you a day after. Do you even call your chummy or your husband or your wife? Darling, did you hear what Pastor Tao say? He said we should come to church tomorrow. No, he's talking to himself. He's not talking to me. But on Sunday, Daddy, can I make you coffee? Can I make it tea? I service. They smile with you right now. But after a minute, they will laugh at you in church. But at home, I service love. Hallelujah for the Lord our God Jehovah. In church, on praise and worship. Because they want to show everybody that they just done a need. After praise and worship, on Wednesday, call them to come and walk here. They say, for where? For where? Walk here. Come on. I service. Your love for God is I service. Okay, next Sunday, next Saturday is our evangelism. No, my own love is only for God on Sunday service in the morning. I service love to God. To God. I service is pretension or casual love. It's not in your inner. And then the last one, and that's where I will stop. So that I can prophesy, I can read something within a few minutes. This one is called deadly zeal or deadly love. They are here. They are here. They are hearing me now. Deadly zeal. They have the zeal for the Lord, but that zeal is poisonous zeal for God. They can destroy what they labor for in their department, in the of an eyes. They can be in protocol, they can be in worship team, they can be in technical, but their love is deadly. Have you not seen a situation where a keyboardist or a drummer just ignore morning service without any attention, without any notice? And nobody, he did not even replace somebody. It's called what? Deadly love. And ask him or her, where are you? I went to Hallelujah is Coming Church to go and play. He loved God, yes or no? That's why he went there. But where he left, he doesn't care whether you die or it's deadly love. They have, it's called poisonous love. They are in church, protocol, worship team, pastorate, technical, but what they produce out among the group, among the leaders, is deadly. What they say out to God is deadly. In fact, it can make God to say, I regret creating you. They are. In fact, and this one is dangerous one because everything about them, you can see that they love God, but their eyes and their smiling is deadly love. When they smile to you, you must know that they have already killed you. And when they now kiss you, they have buried you. That was the same love we saw with Judas. We call them Judas' seal. Judas's seal. Judas's seal. Judas was a man that guided everything. Left and right. He was the accountant, he was the cashier, he was the everything. But in his heart, his eyes, his heart are poisonous. He said, whosoever that I kiss. That's how close he is to the master. Many of us, we are close to God. But our heart and our thought, our lips are poisonous, deadly. The truth of the matter is this. You can poison me, you can poison God, you can poison the work of God. You are poisoning yourself. Because what end in Judas is what end in people that have Judas's love. Do you love him? Do you love God? I'm asking you again, Pastor Lani, do you love God? You see now, you are calm now because you have heard the truth. You have heard the truth. Now, when I said to you that when Jesus was saying, but I know you, that ye have not the love of God in you. You ask me, say, why? How? And I've proven it to you now. That all of us, including me, hello, including me, Namanga. Hey, Namanga. Your love is fake. Your love of God is what? Fake. We love God. We love God. As I'm talking now, some of you are already looking at your wristwatch. Let this man finish what he's going to say now. Some customer are waiting for me. I'm going to meet some customer. And you say you love him. Deadly love is destructive love. Hallelujah. I'll end up there. How can I show my love to God? Your zeal. Let your zeal be measured. I'm going to help you. I'm going to help you this month to reprogram your mind. To reprogram your heart. If you choose to. It's either yes or no. Do you want God's miracle? Align your mind. I'm not talking about even your faith today. Align your love. Reposition your love. Because you don't even know what's called faith. Or your faith is dead or is dying already. But you can realign yourself towards the love of God. And then your faith will come back. And when you see his miracle, you will know indeed that this is God. I will help you.
Amen. Amen. I just want to thank God, the God of this house. Why I say the God of this house? It's because people, they change churches looking for miracles. You can change church, but you cannot change God. Amen. You know, I have seen that there is God here.
Amen.
I have seen. I know not because of only this testimony. There was a week we went up with Daddy when I came first with Granny, Granny Frida. She was shaking because every time she was telling a story, she would shake. Daddy said something that made sense spiritually, but here on earth, it didn't make sense. Daddy said to that granny that day, this story will change. Your situation will change before the end of next month. The God that I serve will change your situation. Everything happened. For 11 years, no one could help that granny. It was on TV on Friday. on Tuesday.
Tuesday.
Tuesday. You know, I wanted everybody to see and to believe that a prophet, when he speaks, you must just believe and receive. Mm. Even if it doesn't make sense. Daddy said, your situation will change. Mm. Before the end of next month, just like that, the daughter moved out. Mm. The police couldn't move the girl out. Mm. The neighbors, the son called. This is the woman who was with Mpo. She was with her. Mm. She was being interviewed. You saw her on TV.
I saw. I will play it last Sunday.
The story has changed. Daddy, you said it, and just like that, it happened.
Amen.
Clap your hands for Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen. 2 weeks back, needed, I received 72-hour miracle.
Amen.
I got the money that I was looking for to start a business with a friend of mine. Mm. I am selling slippers. They are going like amakuinya, hot cakes. Mm. I cannot even supply.
Oh, yeah.
I can't. People, they are looking. I've got orders as far as Palm Spring.
Oh,
people want them.
Amen.
You know why I'm saying I started this business? It's because it's good to work. Mm. But when you are working, you must wait for month end.
Yes.
During the month, you have nothing.
Mm.
So I said, Lord, there was a Sunday. I came here. I knelt down here. I said, Lord, change my story.
Mm.
I want my business back. Mm. Just like that. Even the driving school started working by now.
Right,
so
right.
I just want to thank God. The God of Wami is doing wonders. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Give the Lord a clap offering. Amen. Okay. To prove to you that we serve a miracle God, because if you don't believe all this miracle, I don't know what you want to believe. In fact, if you don't believe in all this miracle that God is in this house, this door is open for you, this gate is open for you, you can take your bag, even right now. Because if you don't believe all this miracle, who would you believe? What would you believe? Here, this is on the Facebook, sent to us on YouTube. YouTube. It was sent to us on YouTube from Victor Case. Casey or Casey. I read it for you. He said, in the name of the Almighty God, I'm sharing this testimony. I'm not giving untrue testimony here. And if I do, my God punish me. I really don't know when this video was published or where and which church it was filmed in. But I came across this video on YouTube. And I watched it on Friday, 18th May. Our month of what? Mega arrival. When I'm speaking to you, I say, I'm not speaking to only 20, 50 of you that are seated here. I am sent to nations. And with your eyes, you will soon see them. When I'm talking about, when the nation will be practically represented where we are seated. He said, at about 11 p.m. at night in bed, I watched the video. And I was amazed by the first guy who received the immediate text of a transfer testimony. So I started declaring, I receive, I receive. I grabbed my bank card and did just like the people in the video did. Then I felt asleep. On Saturday, 19th of May, at 3:30 p.m., I went to visit my young brother. He told me that him and his wife have saved some money to bless me. I was shocked. To bless me, they gave me $2,000. $2,000. I was choked, and became so emotional because I was very broke. Then I remember this video for the miracle money. I wanted to upload a screenshot of that deposit here, but I can't attach it. Anyways, thank you, Pastor. I don't know your name or your ministry, but God has anointed you to speak that miracle prayer for many. For those who haven't received anything yet, just have faith. God loves, and has big promises for you. The ride is yet to come. God bless you all. From New Zealand. Studio, you can capture it. Come and take it and put it on the screen. Say confirmation of God. Say confirmation of God. Another breaking news. On the YouTube. May 31st. May 31st. On Thursday, May 31st, 2018, at 4:32 p.m., printed this message from our YouTube and our Facebook. Facebook. It read, I, from Cherry Chew, he said, I, blessing from Raleigh, North Carolina, United States of America. 2 weeks ago, almost the same time that the New Zealand was capturing, also this one was capturing. 2 weeks ago, I had Pastor Taru prophetic service on finances in 72 hours. I asked Holy Spirit, if this is where you want me to sow, I have 50 US dollar seed. If this man is a man of God and a prophet, make it to come to pass in 72 hours. That was on Thursday. Isn't that not also on Thursday or what? That was Thursday. Then, and on Saturday morning, the breakthrough came in a crazy way. Through a doctor treating my husband. Over 3,000 US dollar harvest. Over 3,000 US dollar harvest. Come on, give the Lord a clap of you. She said, the seed is still in my hand. I'm trying to get to you. I do not see a website to credit card information. Do you have a cash application where I can drop my seed of miracle? Love and blessing, Cherry Morachu. And then we reply. This is our reply. We bless God for your testimony. Unfortunately, we do not have any online donation system. However, if it is within your spirit to sow a seed to this ministry, you are welcome. We don't force people. You can send your donation to our senior pastor directly via Western Union. Every free will donation to our ministry are always announced to the church for your further blessing. Please use below address. And then she replied at 5:43, same day. He said, I am sending Western Union now. I'm sending Western Union now. The question to answer is, what is the sender's favorite color? Answer is purple. And then she sent the Western Union. New Zealand. and there are so many people even that say, please, can you send us your video? We say, where can I buy it? He said, can we, where? I said, we don't send their video. It's on the YouTube. Just print it. Or send us your address, we'll courier it to you. If you cannot see all these testimonies, what do you see? You are seeing the bad report, but there are good reports passing you by. Believe God of this commission that you are next in line for miracle. As if that is not enough, come and go and show this one to the studio. In the beginning of the month, I put my own prayer expectation here. I put it here. I can't find it. It's too much. I said, Lord, this month, show yourself. Show your hand. There is, I've mentioned this sometimes ago to all of you, in the about 2 or 3 months, that there was something that I've been waiting for the past 15 years. For the past 15 years. And about 2 or 3 months, the Lord gave me specific instruction what to do, and I applied it. And the following day, I got a response. Now, on Sunday, last week Sunday, as I was praying here and declaring, before you leave the service, SMS is waiting for you. When we got upstairs, I took my phone. Go and bring my phone, Winnet. At 9:30 or 10:30 a.m., message was on my phone. He said, Pastor, I've been trying to reach you. He said, finally, that the paper has been released. What? 15 years in waiting. It makes me look like, are you not a prophet? You speak to people's life. But when my God of 72 hours, with my persistence, faith in him, listen to me. If you can't believe these testimonies. And how many of you saw my art last Sunday? If you can't believe all this, who do you believe? It's not about the crowd. It's about you. You follow the crowd, you will miss in the crowd. If you miss your root, you will miss your fruit. I'm begging you, if I need to beg you, believe in the God of this commission. Forget about who left, who stayed. If you also want to leave, you can leave today. In fact, you can stop coming from Wednesday or from Sunday. But if you truly believe that your testimony is here, your answer is here, this is why me, this is my own, stay. You will soon share all this testimony. We shall hear your own testimony even more than on YouTube. CNN will announce your own testimony. Pastor Alani, sit down. I don't know which report you want to believe. Please believe God's report. Believe all this is a pointer to you. You see what you have done here now? If you will walk by it and by your faith, you will begin to share testimony from today. From today. I serve a God of 72 hours, and I've been always telling you that if it is not 72 hours, it's just in jail. Somebody is getting a testimony this week that will surprise your enemy. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Anyway, how many of you believe my story? I don't need to read it for you, but if you don't believe it, come to the office. I will open it for you. On Sunday, the message was already waiting for me. On Sunday, 10 a.m. of 9 a.m. That means as I was declaring it, the angel was also propelling, send it now, send it now, send it now. When you open your phone after the service, same miracle is waiting for you.